Hello guys, this is Madhur Agarwal once again, and welcome to the Sunday Capsule podcast. Congratulations, we are now available on almost all the major listening platforms. So let's get started. Recently, the winners of National Startup Awards 2020 in India were announced. And I was quite amazed with the sheer amount of creativity in the inventions and ideas. But the invention that left me awestruck, and even the judges, was the final one. The Aloe cell. Yes, you heard it right. They have literally made a chemical cell, you know, that we use in our remotes, flashlights, using aloe vera. It's probably the world's first battery on which in capital letters, the word non-toxic is written. It is also followed by some more unconventional statements like non-explosive and made from aloe vera. All the credit goes to the creative minds that actually founded this company, Mr. Naveen Suman and Nimisha Verma. Good job guys, you made us proud. Now let's try to find out on which principle it works. First, let's find out how a normal alkaline battery works. In a pencil cell, energy is stored as chemical energy and is converted to electrical energy when needed. As we all know that electricity is just a flow of electrons, and what battery does is just to actually push the electrons so as they continue to flow. They can do that by creating a potential difference for a limited period of time. Just like a typical electrochemical cell, it has cathode, anode and an electrolyte, followed by certain changes in order to make the cell portable and compact. For example, instead of one material, it uses manganese dioxide plus graphite as cathode, which enhances the electrical conductivity. It also has a fibrous barrier which prevents the direct contact between cathode and anode and leaves enough space for the ions to pass through it. It uses potassium hydroxide as an electrolyte. Its alkaline nature is the reason for its name. And for the anode, it uses zinc with some chelling agent in order to prevent coagulation. Now, let's try to find out on what principle does the Aloe cell works. As we all know about photosynthesis, in which plants synthesize carbohydrates from carbon dioxide and water via light energy. This process will cause the electron transport, which creates a potential difference between roots and leaves. This phenomenon is triggered on the plant by the periodic changes in light. Under this condition, plants can generate up to 50 millivolts of potential difference. Not only photosynthesis, but respiration in response to external stimuli also generate potential difference. While all plants can do that, but aloe vera has been observed to generate the highest magnitude of voltage and current. The generated energy with the help of combination of capacitors can be stored for further use. According to our research, zinc and copper is the best combination for electrodes for maximum energy output. I don't know for sure whether the aloe cell works exactly on that or not, but I can surely tell that there has been yet a lot to discover in this expanding universe.